and I'm going to be showing you how to make this band. I call it a sandwich band, but it's not, because there's no real name for it. It's technically single loop inside there, with single loop on the outside, and you use two different colours to make single loop. And so you'll need about four colours, unless you do your strap the same colour as that, which I don't, and a rainbow loom that looks like that. Right, and you want the U facing towards you. Kind of makes sense. Okay, so getting the loom itself, you'll need U facing, like, so you can see the U that, facing towards you. So I'm going to do mine. You're doing the outside part first, so this green bit you're doing first. I'm going to do mine in black, I think. So all you need is two strips of the loom. So you'll only need the middle strip and one of the outside strips. So you go like that, then all the way up to the top, and then come back down to the bottom, and you get to the top of this row, all the way up. And make sure you're pushing them down as you go along, otherwise it'll be hard for you to hook, because if they come off, then you've got to start all over again, or struggle to put it back on by taking half the band off. So when you get to about there, you're going to miss this peg out completely and go straight to that peg there, that peg, and then you're not going to go back down there, you're going to go up there. And again, make sure you're pushing them down as you go. Right, so we need to snatch it like that. So all the way up. Now, I'm going to go along and push them all down. I've pushed the majority of mine down, it's okay. So I have to push all the bones at the bottom. And you need the two colours that are going to go in the middle. So I'm going to use, orange and blue, I think. So, first colour, diagonal light, so there we're going to do a single loop. And second colour, diagonal light, so there. Do it all the way up. They're not overlapping. This isn't that, didn't take that long. The hooking part was quite hard. Pushing them down as you go along. In this part there's no more to go on, so technically just that part, beginning, you need to push them down unless you're going to add something else to it, like a channel or something, but I wouldn't on this band because you won't be able to see it. All the way to there. So I'd finish on the blue. I think. Yeah, finish on the blue. Just go all the way along, making sure none of them are overlapping. So push them there. That side. Now you're going to have to put
capping band on.
So the capping band, you want to get either two blacks or a blue and an orange. I'm black. And two fingers one and try. Do it more than two on. First one. On there. Make sure. So maybe we can get around again. Just okay. Again. So. Round. If you can, do it again. Keep your fingers. You can pull in there as well. That one back as well. So one, two, three. Pick up your fingers. Push it through. Right. Okay. Now I'm going to have it so first. So you can see. And then, okay, come on. For me, I can see you well over there. So I'm gonna just look around so I can see an end. Now I can see the end. If you look, I can see the end like you did before and you can see the U. What you can do quickly, get your hook. First of all, go down into there and get the blue and over back onto it, and you can do that all the way down, go to the orange, pull over to the blue. Pull over to the orange, get the orange, pull over to the blue, get the blue, pull over to the orange. You can do that all the way down. All the way along. I sort of made this pattern up. It's not hard, I wouldn't class it as a very skilled one. Of course it's like medium hard and it's quite simple if you know how to do a single loop, because that's technically all is all the way along. Single loops. And if you want, you can comment at the bottom for any more you need tutorials on or what you can name this. As I've told you already, I call it sandwich, but it's not really a very proper name for it. It's just until someone comments on your name for it. Okay, right. And get all the way to the bottom. Well, the top for me, the bottom for you. You're going to start up here again. This time you're going to go into your second cap band. And get the top one. You're going to go all the way down to the bottom. Get through, pull over, on the top of the blue. Through, pull over, on the top of the blue. Go all the way down. So you go right to the bottom, and then at the bottom, you will go back to the top and do exactly the same down the other side. And it's quite hard because you're trying to pull all these off, because if you pull them off then it just won't work and you've got to start again. And that does get annoying. So, pull over the blue, place in the blue, start the same way down until you get to the end. Now, right, so you don't go back up because then it won't work. Go back to the top up here, go into the same cap band you've been in, get the last band in there and go up to there. Right, pull it down, go to the bottom, get to the bottom of all these black bands, get the bottom band, pull it over to there, get down to the bottom, pull it over to the orange. Sorry, sorry. All down, over to the bottom, orange. All down, over to the orange. pull over to the orange. And then when you get to the bottom, you'll need a S or C clip. I prefer S clips because I find them easy to use. You might not, so use an S or C clip. I'll be using an S clip. And once you get way to the end. Make sure you are going all the way down to the bottom, because if you don't go all the way down to the bottom, it's not connecting them all together. It won't work as well. Right, when we get to the end, as you can see, there's four different bands under there. So, where are my S clips? Yeah. S or C clip. I've got some C clips in here, but I've prefer not to use them. So you're going to get an S clip, I'll get a coloured one. You can see there, so I've got a pink one. I'm going to go all the way into there. Pull it all the way out, make sure you've got all the bands. Pull it all the way out. Just hook your S clip onto every single band. Make sure you've got every band before you let go of them. So pull. Hook all the bands. I can't get that one. There we go. And then you're going to let go. Make sure I've got more on it. Oh, they fell off. Oh, it's annoying. Pull it out. Hook them all. Is that hooked them all? Yep. And then get the S clip itself. Also, you click the new, pull it. Pull all the bands off. You should have got that, your sandwich band, or whatever you want to call it. Now, you pull that to one side, and when you're black, make sure you've got used here. And you're going to just do a nice, simple, straight line all the way to the top. I use about 7 or 8. Depends how wide your wrist is, so once you're finished you can always take them off. I'm going to put one more on and put this one on.
How many?
Really want to. Because I've used 6, so I'll just put another one. Right. Now you get this, and the side that's hooked with the S clip, you leave, but then you find your last cap band. Hook that on the last peg of your thing. Then it looks like that. It still needs to be double looped though, and then you're going to hook it, so turn it around, go down to the black, and just single loop it all the way down. And then at the bottom, just get, so once you've finished it, leave the bottom one on, because obviously that's not attached to anything, that'll just fall off. Unless you're going to finish it off properly, which I'm not going to do, I'm just going to hook it onto my S-clip. So when you get to the bottom like that, every single loop, so if you just pull it off now, it'll just fall off. So you're going to take all this off, so you can pull this side off, pull them all off, put it down. Don't take that bottom one off. And then you're going to pull it like that and hook your S clip onto it, take it off. There you have it, your sandwich band.